Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to learn about the register storage class. Okay, so normally we are going to see the different properties of the register storage class. So that is storage, default, initial value, scope and lifetime. Okay, so here normally the computer is going to store in two memory allocations, that is in two types of storage it is going to save, that is registers or memory. So here it is going to store the data, the variable in the register, and the default initial value is the garbage value. So we are not giving any initial value here, so the compiler will take the garbage value which is unpredictable, and the scope of the variable is local to the block where the variable is defined. Okay, and lifetime is till the control remains within the block in which variable is defined. Okay, so to store the local variables within the functions or blocks in CPU registers instead of RAM to have the quick access to these variables. So why we are using the register storage class means the basic purpose is we can access the variables faster compared to the memory. Okay, so in the registers we can access the data very quickly compared to the memory. So that's why we are going to store the local variables or functions in the CPU registers. Okay, so instead of RAM we are going to store them in the CPU registers to access the variables quickly. Okay, so here the registers are very fast and it has a limited storage space, but the memory is having the storage space, but it is little bit slow compared to the registers. Okay, so now in that scenario the variable works as storage class is auto. Okay, so normally the CPU registers will be very busy doing certain remaining tasks regarding the operating system and memory management. Okay, so that's why if the CPU registers are, so that's why the CPU registers are limited. So in that case the variable will work as auto storage class. Okay, so if the CPU registers are busy in some the operating system or memory management work, then it is going to consider that particular variable as a auto storage class variable. And here we cannot obtain the address of a register variable using the pointers. Okay, so this is about the register storage class in the C language. Okay, so thanks for watching my video. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.